Dear students, I am Dr. Chaudhary. I welcome you all to this video, Laplace Transform in Engineering Mathematics 2. In this video, I would like to share my ideas how to find the Laplace transformation of the function by using division by T4n formula and change of scale property. So first we see the theorem of Laplace transformation based on division by T4n. If L of f of t equal to f of s and limit f of t by t exists when t tends to 0, then L of f of t by t equal to integral s to infinity L of f of t ds, that is integral s to infinity f of s into ds. Now let us see the proof of this theorem. We know the formula L of f of t equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t dt. Here L of f of t equal to f of s. In multiplicity formula, we differentiate with respect to s on both sides, but here we are integrating with respect to s from s to infinity on both sides. So taking integration with respect to s to infinity on both sides. So integral s to infinity f of s ds equal to integral s to infinity integral 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t dt ds. Here the function e power minus st only the function of s, so integral s to infinity e power minus st ds. Therefore integral e power minus st value e power minus st divided by minus t limit s to infinity. Applying the limit infinity and s, e power minus infinity minus e power minus st divided by minus t. Simplifying this, we can get integral 0 to infinity e power minus st into f of t divided by t. This is of the form integral 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t dt. In the place of f of t, we have f of t divided by t. Now this integral value equal to L of f of t. Therefore, the above integral can be written as L of f of t divided by t. In extension, we can write L of f of t divided by t power n equal to integral s to infinity, integral s to infinity up to integral s to infinity f of s ds power n. One example to understand the concern. Find the value of L of sin a t by t. This is of the form L of f of t by t. Therefore, here f of t equal to sin a t. So Laplace transformation of sin a t equal to a by a square plus a square. This is f of s. By divisibility formula, L of sin a t by t equal to integral s to infinity L of sin a t ds. So substitute L of sin a t value here. Now this is of the form integral dx by x square plus a square. So what is the result? 1 by a into a tan inverse of s by a limits s to infinity. So numerator a and denominator a will be cancelled outside. Apply the upper limit and lower limit inside the bracket. So tan inverse of infinity minus tan inverse of s by a. Tan inverse of infinity value equal to pi by 2. So pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s by a. So we have proved Laplace transformation of sin a t by t exists. Now we are going to check the Laplace transformation of cos a t by t exists or not. How do we check this result? We know that limit f of t by t exists when t tends to 0, then only L of f of t by t exists. So apply here limit cos a t by t when t tends to 0. Answer cos 0 by 0. What is the value? 1 by 0 equal to infinity. Therefore, cos a t by t is not continuous at t equal to 0. Therefore, Laplace transformation of cos a t by t does not exist. Now only proved Laplace transformation of cos a t by t does not exist. But how we are going to find the value of L of cos a t minus cos b t by t? This is the form of L of f of t by t. Already we know that cos a t by t, cos b t by t are not continuous at t equal to 0. But cos a t minus cos b t by t is continuous at t equal to 0. Therefore, Laplace transformation of cos a t minus cos b t by t exists. Therefore, f of t equal to cos a t minus cos b t. So the corresponding Laplace transformation L of cos a t minus cos b t. Now using the formula, L of cos AT equal to S by S square plus A square and L of cos BT equal to S by S square plus B square. Therefore, L of cos AT minus cos BT equal to, using the linear property, we can write L of cos AT minus L of cos BT. Apply the above results here. Now, the given problem L of cos AT minus cos BT vector equal to integral S to infinity S by S square plus A square minus S by S square plus B square ds. Since integral satisfies the linear property, therefore we can write like this. See the numerator and denominator for the both the two integrals. Numerator is the differential form of the denominator. So using the substitution method, we rewrite the given integral as 1 by 2 into integral s to infinity 2s by s square plus a square ds minus 1 by 2 into integral s to infinity 2s by s square plus b square ds. So we know the result. 1 by 2 into log of s square plus a square minus log of s square plus b square. Now log m minus log n formula, log m by n, apply here. Then we apply the limit, upper limit infinity and lower limit s. Substitute here, we can get the result 1 by 2 into log of s square plus b square by s square plus a square. Now just go through how you got this above result. Now, how we are going to apply the infinity value in log function? Taking s square from numerator and denominator, cancelling these two, you may get this result. Substitute the upper limit infinity and lower limit s. Log 1 value 0. So that, and minus comes the inverse function of this one. So that, the result goes to 1 by 2 log of s square plus b square by s square plus a square. Also, you may think that how the limit of cos AT minus cos BT by T exists when T tends to 0. Let us see the reason now. This is only for understanding purpose, so no need to write in exam. Apply the T value equal to 0 in this given function, cos 0 minus cos 0 by 0. So 1 minus 1 divided by 0, this is of the form 0 by 0. So using L-Hospital rule, differentiate the numerator and denominator with respect to T. So limit T tends to 0, minus a sin at plus b sin bt divided by 1, because cos at differentiation minus a sin at, already minus is there, cos bt differentiation minus b sin bt, therefore it comes plus. Substitute t value equal to 0, minus a sin 0 plus b sin 0 divided by 1, answer 0 by 1 equal to 0. So limit cos at minus cos bt by t exists, which implies Laplace transformation cos AT minus cos BT by T exist. Now let us see another example. Find the value of L of e power AT minus e power minus BT divided by T. This is of the form L of f of t divided by t. So we are taking f of t equal to e power at minus e power minus bt. So first we have to find the Laplace transformation of this function. So L of e power at minus e power minus bt equal to, using linear property, L of e power at minus L of e power minus bt. Now we know the standard results of these two functions, 1 by s minus a minus 1 by s plus b. Now we are going to use the division formula. L of e power at minus e power minus bt divided by t, that can be written as integral s to infinity Laplace transformation of the function into ds. Apply the value here, the answer log of s minus a minus log of s plus b limit s to infinity. Now before you apply the limit values, make it log m minus log n equal to log of m by n, that is log of s minus a divided by s plus b. See the limits, upper limit infinity and lower limit s. We know the standard result, when the limit comes upper limit infinity and lower limit s, we can write log of the inverse of the given function, therefore log of s plus b divided by s minus a. Here I have given the reference how we got the above result. This is only for the understanding purpose only. It is not necessary to write in exam. If you want, you may write it answer. Now see this example. Previously we have worked out the problem t with the power 1, here t with the power 2. Find the value of L of 1 minus cos t divided by t square. this is of the form L of f of t divided by t square. So, as per the rule, we are taking f of t equal to 1 minus cos t. Find the Laplace transformation of this function. Answer 1 by s minus s by s square plus 1. Now we are going to use the division formula. L of 1 minus cos t divided by t square equal to double integral L of 1 minus cos t ds ds. Already we have found L of 1 minus cos t value. Substitute here. Now, before we are going to integrate the problem, just to make it the second term 1 by 2 into 2s by s square plus 1 for applying the substitution method. Now we are going to apply the inner integral first. Integral 1 by s goes to log s. And see the second term, numerator is the differential form of the denominator. So by the substitution method, the result is log of s square plus 1. And make it the first term as 1 by 2 into log s square. So that 1 by 2 is common between the two terms. Take it outside. 1 by 2 into integral s to infinity log of s square divided by s square plus 1. See the limit. Upper limit is infinity, lower limit is s. Whenever we have the form comes like this, we can write log of the reciprocal of the function. So 1 by 2 into integral s to infinity log of s square plus 1 divided by s square. Now we are going to integrate the function with respect to s. Before that, we make it some simplification. Log m by n formula, log m minus log n. So that log s square plus 1 minus log s square. Also, to make the more simplification, log s square can be written as 2 into log s. Now you have already learned how to find the integral value of log function using the technique integration by parts. So integral u dv equal to uv minus integral v du. So here we are taking u equal to log of s square plus 1 minus 2 into log s, dv equal to ds. So differentiating u, du equal to log of s square plus 1 differentiation 2s by s square plus 1 minus 2 into log s differentiation 1 by s and differentiation of s ds. And taking integration of dv equal to integration of ds, answer v equal to s. Now substitute all the values in the formula u into v minus integral v into du and multiply 1 by 2 inside the bracket and simplify the first term. It goes to 1 by 2 into s into log of s square plus 1 divided by s square. And see the second term. See the denominator s square plus 1 and s. Taking LCM s into s square plus 1 and using cross multiplication, it becomes 2s square minus 2s square minus 2. The 2s square minus 2s square may be cancelled. Now look at the first term. We are going to substitute the limit values. See the upper limit infinity, lower limit is the variable s. While we substitute the limit value infinity, log of s square plus 1 divided by s square goes to 0. So 0 into anything 0. Therefore, the first term goes to 1 by 2 into 0 minus s into log of s square plus 1 divided by s square. Look at the second term, minus 1 by 2 into minus 2, that may be cancelled. Therefore, second term comes plus integral s to infinity ds by s square plus 1. Now, we are using the formula n into log m formula. Therefore, the first term goes to s by 2 into log of s square divided by s square plus 1. See the second term, the standard result, tan inverse of s, limit s to infinity. Apply the limit value infinity and s, we can get pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s. This is the required answer. Also, we can derive pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s formula, cot inverse of s. See this example, shifting and disability both comes together. Find the value of L of e power minus 3t into sin 2t divided by t. Here, sin 2t role elementary function. E power minus 3t stands for shifting operator. T is stands for disability. Therefore, taking f of t equal to sin 2t. Find the Laplace transformation of f of t. What is the answer? 2 by s square plus 4. Now, we are going to apply the first shifting property. L of e power minus 3t into sin 2t. What is the answer? Laplace transformation of sin 2t, where s shifted to s plus 3. Therefore, the result is 2 by s plus 3 whole square plus 4. Now we apply the division formula. Laplace transformation of e power minus 3t into sine 2t divided by t equal to less to infinity Laplace transformation of this function. The result 2 by s plus 3 whole square plus 4. Here 4 can be written as 2 square. This is of the form dx by x square plus a square equal to 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a. Here the numerator 2, take it outside. So 2 into 1 by 2 into tan inverse of s plus 3 divided by 2. Limit s to infinity. Now we apply the upper limit and lower limit. Tan inverse of infinity minus tan inverse of s plus 3 divided by 2. So what is the answer? Pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s plus 3 divided by 2. Also we can write cot inverse of s plus 3 divided by 2. Now see the another important property, change of scale property. If L of f of t equal to f of s, then L of f of a t equal to 1 by a into f of s by a. Now see how we are going to prove this result. We know that Laplace transformation of f of t equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t dt. Here f of t equal to f of a t. Using substitution method, taking u equal to at, therefore du equal to a into dt. Now t can be written as u by a, dt can be written as du by a. Here we are taking u equal to directly t, therefore there is no change in the limit. So L of f of u equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus s u by a into f of u into du by a. Now we rewrite this integral as like this. Now this is of the form of integral 0 to infinity e power minus st f of t dt. Here the place of s we have s by a. Therefore the answer is 1 by a into f of s by a. Now let us see an example based on the change of scale property. Given that L of sin t by t equal to tan inverse of 1 by s, then how we are going to find the value of L of sin a t by t? By using change of scale property, L of f of a t equal to 1 by a into f of s by a. From the given problem, f of t equal to sin t by t, corresponding f of s equal to tan inverse of 1 by s. Therefore, f of a t equal to replacing t by a in the above one, sin a t by a t. And replacing s by a, we can get f of s by a equal to tan inverse of 1 by s by a, that is tan inverse of a by s. Now, L of sin a t by a t equal to, as by the change of scale property, 1 by a into tan inverse of a by s. Taking 1 by a outside in left hand side, 1 by a into L of sin a t by t equal to 1 by a tan inverse of a by s. Cancelling 1 by a on both sides, you may get Laplace transformation of sin a t by t equal to tan inverse of a by s, which is the required result. You work out all this problem for better practice. If you have any doubt, ask me and your faculty. And also, you refer the material which is uploaded in the Google Classroom. In this next lecture, we will see Laplace transform of periodic functions, derivatives, and integrals. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you have understood how do we find the Laplace transformation of the function based on divisibility formula and change of scale property. Share and subscribe.